Alright, so Monday, 21st October. I was going to visit the park yesterday, but the weather was terrible, so let's see what we see. There's something I want to revisit. I'll come to that later. Right, so here we go again with the bell tower, because it used to have a bell up top. Oh, big steps. Okay. Right, you see in there the fireplace. I've never seen a chimney. So there you have it, no chimney. Alright, so this is the thing I wanted to double check. I've got the figures right. 133,516 aircrew cadets. Right, stationed here World War II, en route overseas for flying training. Now that would give you the impression that there's going to be that number of pilots. Old Trafford, I think that holds about 70,000, so you're talking about two of them near enough. Maybe if anybody knows more about it, it just seems an incredible amount of people. 133,516. Another one over the sundial. I remember as a child in the 1950s, the boys in the drive would get together and would make up this guy thing and stick it in a bogey. A bogey being a kind of wooden box with pram wheels on it. And we'd go about the district asking for a penny for the guy, sort of thing. Usually get told where to go, but sometimes some people gave us money. This one's got a broomstick and a hanky in its nose. Look at those shoes, isn't they smart? So this one's got village people vibes about it, remember? It's fun to stay at the YMCA. Now here's another one. Right, from the back, is this an astronaut? Oh no, it'll be a beekeeper. Very good. Going ahead this way, again for a change. Is it St. Margaret entrance? And also maybe check out the reservoir. Community orchard. The heck's that? Let's see what this is. Community orchard. I must be missing something. Unless some of these are apple trees. Right, Right, I've been told this is the area, so some of these might be fruit trees, I don't know. Oh look, there's an apple. Like most of my excursions, it's probably the wrong time of year. Okay. Nothing to see here. Right, heading back. Oh yeah, there's some up there. This camera won't show it, but there are apples up there. There's some there. Oh look, tons of apples here. Whoa! Here's something else I've never seen before. Tree top, something or other. Tell you, this park amazes me. I've been coming here for years and I keep finding something new. No idea what that is. Fast flowing water. Must have something to do with the reservoir, I assume. Just come back round here to get the name of this place. Trampoline there. No access. Right, still no idea what it's called. Looks good fun if you're a certain age. Right, I'm back at this spot. See what's going on here. And that's the reservoir up there. Quite a few years ago I climbed that grass embankment somewhere you could get access to it. And I got to the top eventually and could see nothing. Still couldn't see any water. Well, here's this thing, something to do with water supply. Very good. You can see water running down there. All good things are it's fenced off. Well, my intention is, if I can find somewhere with no trees above me, I'll try putting the drone up and see what I can see. This bit looks okay. Right, I'll try it here. Let the drone connect. And straight up. See what's happening. Okay. Right, well, that was the reservoir. I am the worst drone pilot you'll ever meet. The bowling club there. So I believe the garden centre, and there's a cafe up there. Right, I'm going to go to the main entrance here. I've never really seen it before, I don't think. Certainly never studied it. So we'll have a look at the St. Margaret entrance and then come back to the cafe. Yeah, it turned out nice again.
In the chilly hours and minutes of uncertainty, I want to be in the warm heart of your love and mine.
Hiya, hello.
To feel you all around me, and to take your hand along the sand. I bet I may as well try and catch the wind. When sundown pales the sky, I want to hide a while behind your smile, and everywhere I'd look, your eyes would find. For me to love you now would be the sweetest thing. 'Twould make me sing. I bet I may as well try and catch the wind. All my blues behind. For standing in your heart is where I want to be and long to be. I bet I may as well try and catch the wind.
Football goalposts. So these are the football pitches I've been hearing about, that where all the litter gets strewn. And even from here you can see the sun glistening in all the plastic bottles. That is bad, isn't it? I mean, really, there's no need for that. I know that sometimes, you know, like near litter bins, you often get a mess, but that's because of foxes or the magpies pulling the stuff out to get some food. So there we are, 1, 2, 3. Three large football pitches. A load of plastic bottles. Right, I'm going to back up here because I'm going to get a cuppa. Something else I've noticed in this little excursion, the number of car parks. No wonder they have so many, well, not so many, but no wonder they have the guys going down giving out tickets. Spoilt for choice. Right, if I've got my bearings right, this will be where the cafe is. Here we are. The Hidden Gem Coffee Shop, Heaton Park Garden Centre. Is there a cafe down that way? Oh, I see the sign, sorry, thank you. So that was the Hidden Gem Cafe. Very nice it looks too. Plenty of seats, but not much staff doing the kitchen. So I didn't really have time to wait for my hot chocolate. Lovely spot though. Brave. bit here is actually spooky, no matter what time of year it is. Fine fella.
Thank you for the days, those endless days, those sacred days you gave me. I'm thinking of the days. I won't forget a single day, believe me. I bless the light that lights on you.
I've no idea what that is.
And though you're gone, you're with me every single day, believe me. Days I remember.
Oh, well, that's definitely it this time, I promise you. Gonna go to Sainsbury's, get myself a bottle of wine, and probably Netflix or something. Right, bye bye. Here I am back again. I meant to finish on an RAF joke after looking at that sign. So this RAF pilot crash lands in the jungle, okay, and a native comes up to him and says, "Excuse me, Captain, is it anything I can do to help?" And the pilot says, "Yeah, if you can drag me clear of this thing before it goes up and just prop me against a tree." And the native says, "Certainly, sir." So he drags him clear of the aircraft and puts him against a tree. And the pilot says, "You speak very good English for a native. Where did you learn?" He says, "Well, sir, it was actually shortwave radio." I think it's funny.
Thank you for the days, those endless days, those sacred days you gave me. I'm thinking of